Good morning, everyone, from Colorado's greatest disc golf course, also ranked number 20 in the world, Beaver Ranch. It's going to be a wonderful day. It's about 7:30 in the morning, 40 degrees, a little chilly. Going to get a quick start. Today I'm going to play the blues. Only played them a couple times. Personal best was even. That was when I was forehand only. As some of you know, this year trying to work on the backhand, so if I can break even today on the blues backhand, that would be quite fantastic. So let's see what we can do.
Even through one.
Parked.
Pretty good.
I should be right at it, hopefully.
Mm-hmm. Hole five, quite a bit of a touch shot. 205 feet off to the left, just a little bit, tons of trees.
Hole six, we're at even, looking at 275 feet straight forward. Oh, that was gonna be pretty good.
Six.
Feet, par three, down in the Aspens. Definitely one of the top holes on the course. Not sure if I've ever birdied this, but maybe today's the day.
Suppose I will take that.
Beaver Ranch, the number one course in Colorado. I haven't played them all, but played most of the ones in the front range, and my list goes Beaver Ranch, Arapaho Basin, Prickly Pines, Bucksnort, Dillon, Bear Mountain. I've got Beaver Ranch is a perfect 10. They've got three layouts, huge tee pads, all the amenities you could imagine, a putting course, creek at the base, majestic views, and my favorite thing about it is there's not a single branch out of place. The staff here, they just take such meticulous care of this place, you're hardly ever looking for a disc, whereas a lot of other mountain courses, you'll be looking for discs all the time, so big props to them. And
oh, off the tree, off the silver basket. That would have been a cool black hit.
Just curious what the watt will do off this hole.
off the tree, off the basket, and here we are. Wrong basket, though. We got about 80 feet to go.
Hole 9, we're still at even. This one, we're looking at 267, another awesome hole, so that's 4 in a row here.
Sorry guys, it's a bit boring, but I guess right now I am the definition of an average disc golfer in the mountains.
Hole 10, 283 feet, dog leg left. Hole 2 straight, would've been great for the grays.
Hole 11, 310 feet straight downhill. Pretty tricky. Hit a tree, rolled around a bit, but definitely will take it. Hole 12, 214, straight uphill, so it plays quite a bit longer.
Hole 14, believe it or not, still par. 320 feet, dog leg left.
The par show continues. 15, 290, at least from this short path. Another trademark hole on the course. Straight ahead. Gonna have to use the mulligan. Wow, that thing flew.
I tried to get a birdie for y'all, but it's still at par. Hole 16, 222. Again, tricky for the blue. It's a dogleg right, a lot of trees.
Man, thought that was in. Four pars. At least I had a chance to run it
with the trusty floppy.
17, 240 feet. Another classic. Oh my gosh! Nothing will stick.
Hole 18. Still even. This is going to be one of the big obstacles right here. Don't really love this hole. Super tight gap, but if we can get through, we should be good.
Oh. Almost got through. Well, we're 18 holes through. Just took an unfortunate bogey there. Just a really stupid approach, hit one big tree on the way out. Gotta get a birdie, we got three chances. Probably the last hole is gonna be the most
Actually, the last two holes, we got some decent chances. So let's see what we can do.
Was this tree of the year? What a beauty.
Hole 20, 168 feet. Probably the easiest hole on the blue course. And they're trying to give me a break, get me back to even. Let's see if I can do it. Well, plus one is gonna be what it is. I guess I deserve it. Really not a good drive or approach on hole 18. Super fun. I mean, a little frustrating as all mountain disc golf is, but nice morning, not a lot of wind, beautiful weather, some beautiful foliage. It's a great time of year. Thanks for watching.